What is going on, guys? Today we are talking about five things that I absolutely hate about Las Vegas. All right, things that I hate about Vegas, number one. This has been said by multiple people, and I want to make sure to hammer this home if you're watching this video because you're planning on going to Vegas soon. And that is the walking distance. Do not underestimate the distance that you need to walk to get from casino to casino, or even to get outside of your casino down to the strip. We stayed at Bellagio when I was there, and I am not joking when I tell you it took us 25 minutes to get from our room down to the front lobby of the Bellagio. We were on like the fifth floor, we had to take an elevator down, we had to walk clear through the casino, then you get to the front of the casino and you're not even out of the casino by the strip yet. You have to walk by that giant fountain. So, especially where we stayed at the Bellagio, do not underestimate walking distance. We did spend one day walking all around the strip, and it is a lot of walking. Bring really comfortable shoes with you. The second thing that I hated about Las Vegas is every person wants a tip. Even things that you're not used to tipping for at home, the people in Vegas will expect a tip for it. So be prepared for that. You know, where I live, you tip hairdressers, you tip bartenders, you tip your servers, you tip your Uber drivers, you tip your cab drivers, and that's really about it. But not in Vegas. If they're doing anything for you, they're gonna want a tip. And I get it, if it's like a bellboy and they're carrying your bags up to your room for you, by all means, tip them. But don't be surprised when it's someone that you wouldn't think you had to give a tip to, and they're standing right in front of you wanting a tip. All right, guys, if you're getting any kind of value from this video, please smash that like button, hit the bell for notifications. You'll get notified of all the future videos that I do. If you disagree with anything that I've said so far, please, down in the comments, let me know. I love hearing your guys' opinions on things. I learn things from it. So feel free, get in the comments. Let me know if I missed something. Let me know if I got something wrong. I'd really love to hear about it. All right, guys, things I hate about Vegas, number three. And that is Vegas is not camera friendly. I'm a photographer by trade, so I like to take photos, and I run this YouTube channel, so I like to record videos. Well, if you're going to Vegas, be prepared to be hassled for your camera. I had no problems filming at the Bellagio buffet. Once we went to film at In-N-Out, we were asked to leave with the camera. There were a couple places on Fremont Street that I also wanted to do videos at. Again, as soon as they saw me with the camera, they asked me to leave. When we are walking around the strip, I like to do a lot of street photography. I like to do a lot of artsy-like stuff. Be aware that there are showgirls on that strip. They're not just girls, there are guys, there are a lot of people in costume. If they see you walking down the road with a camera, they will harass you. We had two of them follow us for a block, pretty much yelling at me because I wouldn't take photos with them. Now, I didn't take any pictures on my camera of them. I already knew not to do that. These girls and the guys that are out there, they want something around 40 bucks to take a picture with them. Hey, if that's your thing, go ahead. I don't really need pictures with showgirls that badly. But we had a pair following us and yelling at us, oh, you know, you'll take photos on your own, but you won't pay to take photos with us. So expect that. If you're walking around with a big DSLR, you're gonna get some crap for it. I personally really didn't like that. Now in Bellagio, no one really harassed me about taking photos. I was in their conservatory doing some photos there. There's a giant horse with a really nice multicolored ceiling above it. I was taking photos of that. I was taking photos in the Caesars Casino, and no one gave me issues over there either. But anytime we were outside on the strip or trying to film at a restaurant, we were pretty much shut down. That's why I don't have a whole lot of videos from Vegas. So be aware, if you like to take pictures, if you're a photographer and that's why you're going, you're gonna have to kind of do things guerrilla style because not every place is camera friendly. All right, guys, I'm gonna stop the video for a couple seconds. I'm gonna talk about this video's sponsor. This video's sponsor is TubeBuddy. As I say in my videos when I talk about this, I don't sit here and advertise for anything on my videos that I don't personally pay for and use. And TubeBuddy is one of those services. Best of all, you can try it without paying anything. They do have a free option where you can check it out. If you make YouTube videos, if you have a website, if you need internet keywords for any reason, TubeBuddy is fantastic at helping you find these. It will help you with your analytics, it will help you rank your videos, get more views, and get more traffic to your webpage. The link is right here. It's also down below in the description. Make sure that you click on that. I'll get a couple bucks. you'll get to try out TubeBuddy. Again, you don't have to pay for anything in order to give it a shot. So what do you got to lose, guys? All right, now let's get back to the video. The next thing I didn't like about Las Vegas were the prices. Listen, if you're from New York City, or you're from LA, or you're from Boston, these prices may not seem all that bad to you. Where I live, the cost of living is pretty low. You're gonna look at paying around $14 or $15 for a beer in the casino. I believe it was like $14.50 for the beer I was drinking at Bellagio. And contrary to that myth that you can be at the machines and gamble and people will come up to you and give you drinks, I found that to be really few and far between. And we weren't sitting at penny machines. We only gambled one day when we were there, and we spent a few thousand dollars, and we still never saw a waitress. Now, I get a few thousand dollars isn't like high rolling, but to me, a few thousand dollars is a decent amount of money. So don't count on getting your drinks from waitresses while you're at the machines. My personal experience, I didn't see any of them the entire time I was there through the four casinos that we went to. Your food prices are gonna be high while you're there, though there are some cheaper places to eat. I'll go into that a little bit later in the video when I get to the positives. But most of the places, especially in Bellagio, are gonna be pretty pricey. You're also gonna need reservations for these places, at least at Bellagio. Don't think you can just go walk in any of these restaurants when you get hungry. Making sure to plan out where you're eating, when you're eating, and call those places and make sure you have reservations for them is gonna be your best option, so you can make sure to get that meal when you want it. A good tip to make things a little bit more affordable is you can walk down to the strip, go to the CVS, and buy your alcohol at the CVS and bring that up to your room. Make sure you don't touch anything in the mini bar in your room. At least at Bellagio, that's all controlled kind of electronically. Even if you pick something up to look at it, you're gonna get charged for it. And the prices for those things are absolutely insane. We're talking like $20 for a bag of chips. So leave your mini bar alone unless you're kind of rolling in the money. Go over to CVS, pick your stuff up there, and then the prices won't be so bad. It's a little more inconvenient, but if you don't want to pay $15 for a beer, that's probably the best thing for you to do. All right, the other thing I really didn't like about Vegas was the Uber pickup areas. There has been some kind of dispute between the cab companies and Uber drivers. So while an Uber can drop you off at the front door of your casino or the front lobby, whatever you want to call it, they cannot pick you up there. If you want to take an Uber somewhere, you have to walk to a special area of the casino and get your Uber there. We were over at Caesars, and actually that area was pretty hard to find. I had asked three or four people how to get to it, even though there are signs in most of the casinos showing you where to go to get picked up for Uber. Finally, we got back towards the food court and got directed to a door that said, "Do not enter." And we went through that door and it put us outside by Caesar's dumpsters, and we had to walk around the side of the casino for the Uber pickup area. So if you're planning on taking Uber, make sure you are aware that you will have to go to a special area in order to be picked up by one. All right, let's get into a few more positive things here so this video is not super negative. Here are the things that I liked about my Vegas trip. The number one thing I liked was the shows. I went to see Metallica at the Allegiant when I was there. Allegiant's a fantastic place to see a concert. We didn't really have ultra premium seats when we were there, but we had great seats. And looking around, it didn't look like there were very many places to be there where you weren't in a good seat. It's a really great place to see a show. And kind of on a little side note, the concession food in Allegiant was actually cheaper than most of Vegas. So the only bad thing about going to a show at the Allegiant is there is a drop-off spot that's pretty far away from the actual stadium. So you will do a bit of walking to get in there. And then I think the place holds like 30 or 40,000 people. When the show's over and you're getting out, don't even attempt to get an Uber or a cab right there in front of the stadium. Walk yourself to the nearest casino and try and get a cab or an Uber from there, because coming out of those shows is just an absolute madhouse. The other show we went to was Absinthe, which is absolutely fantastic. A friend of mine that I went bought tickets for all of us. I knew nothing about the show before I went. I made sure to keep it that way. I didn't look it up. I didn't read about it. I wanted to be surprised. And I can tell you, it's a fantastic show. If you enjoy adult humor, you will absolutely love it. I can't recommend that show enough. So the shows in Vegas are great. The entertainment in Vegas is great. Walking down Fremont Street, there's always a lot of acts going on in the middle of Fremont Street. I do have another video I'll link down in the description of a spray paint speed artist that was in the middle of the street there. Super, super cool. So the entertainment in Vegas, you can find a lot of things to do. There's also a lot of stuff to do. It doesn't cost a lot of money. The conservatory in the Bellagio was a really cool thing. So were a lot of the statues in Caesars. All the casinos have kind of a different vibe to them. So it's definitely worth checking out. The other thing that I really liked about Vegas is, at least for my stay and at the Bellagio where I stayed, the hotel staff was genuinely nice. If they were just pretending to be nice, they were doing a really good job at it. You know, people in customer service, you know how that goes. You put on a smile, meanwhile in your head, you're kind of cursing someone out. But the people that I dealt with at Bellagio were super helpful, were super nice. Bellagio is a nice casino. It won't be where I stay if I ever go back to Vegas again, but it was nice for my first stay. So that's one of the cool things about Vegas, is customer service, at least in the casinos, is still alive. They do treat you pretty well, even though, you know, I'm not a super high roller. They did treat us very, very well, and I can't say anything negative about Bellagio and their customer service. All right, the other thing I liked about Vegas is reasonable food can be found. You're not going to really find it in Bellagio, but there are plenty of places around town where you can go eat fairly cheaply. In-N-Out Burger is relatively inexpensive to eat at. There are a lot of inexpensive places on Fremont Street. There are a ton of dining options, period. The one thing that I can tell you is that if you are going to eat somewhere, call ahead and find out if they take reservations, because lines can be extremely long and sometimes you can't even get into places. But the dining options in Vegas are vast. If you want to spend a couple $1,000s on a meal, you can do it. If you only want to spend a couple bucks on a meal, you can do it. That's one of the things I really did like about Vegas, is the food options. You could pretty much find anything you want to eat there. If you wanted Thai, if you wanted pizza, if you wanted fine dining, it's all out there in Vegas. All right, guys, so there's my list of things I liked and didn't like from Las Vegas. Please, if you want to add something, if you want to critique something, put it down in the comments. Please, if you're still watching and you got value from this video, like, comment, and subscribe to my channel so you can keep getting new videos. Take it easy, guys. Have a good one.